back in the mini mansion. Doing another boxing video on vacation to show you how much I love the sport. People asked me to comment on the Andrade fight. What did I think of Bute and should he be in the Super Six? I thought for sure he should have been in the Super Six. Andrade is pretty much the Forrest Griffin of boxing. Forrest Griffin from UFC. They kind of look alike, too. When he was getting hit, I'm like, man, he looked like Forrest Griffin. But those two guys right there, he's just a stepping stone for that division. He's a tough guy. He's going to be a tough fight at 168. But the guy's not going to be champion at 168. And if it's old, he'll be some lame brain guy that they just put stock in. But Andrade, skill-wise, is not going to beat one of the elite fighters at 168. He really should be fighting at probably 160. He just can't make 160. And he's a man without a division right now. But Bute, on the other hand, I think there's definitely skill there. I don't think he beats Alan Green because I just don't think he has enough control of his stamina to see if he can go 12 rounds. But he makes an exciting fight. He can pack a crowd. Plus, you know, he's eccentric. He's from Canada, from Romania, so they definitely could sell him. I don't think he can beat Andre Ward. I don't think he could beat Arthur Abram, but he might get Darrell's go for his money. But it would have been exciting to see him in there instead of Jermaine Taylor. Everybody says that now, like, yeah, well, Taylor just lost. It's easy to say that now. But I was saying this beforehand, that Taylor Frosch, the first fight, should have just counted as the tournament. Taylor shouldn't even have been cleared to come back and fight after a vicious knockdown like that. He's been taking too many shots in the ring. The same thing happened with Roy Jones. After he got knocked out from Tarver, he went right back into Glenn Johnson, and then he got knocked out again right away because he didn't take the time off, and they should have given him a longer time off to give his body a chance to heal. It's like what the NFL is doing right now with the concussion. Some fighters really need extra evaluation. Depends on the severity of the blows that they're taking during the fight. Even though they're standing up, they're still taking vicious blows. And time off is, like, needed. Like, Miguel Cotto is completely drained. He's taking a lot of shots. And he's fighting repeatedly. I mean, repeatedly, like, nonstop. I think he needs to take at least a year off before he gets back in the ring. But I'm going to go ahead, walk the family dog, enjoy the mini mansion some more, and then we'll get back in contact with y'all later when I give y'all some more in-depth boxing highlights and interviews, and we'll just go from there. You're probably enjoying the sights that you're seeing here in sunny Florida, out here in Lithia on the ranch. It's beautiful out here. Wish you guys out here enjoying this. Peace. Puerto Rico. Hey.